So let's talk a little bit about the ley lines. As you can see here, I have a red line. That means I'm on port tack and I'm going towards the south. And there's another ley line, the green one, that will be on starboard tack. And they are very useful because they can tell me when to jibe. Like if I would jibe right now, we would be going straight into the island there. So we don't want that. We want to go further south, and once the green ley line clears the island, we can jibe and go that way. So that makes it very easy to decide. They are a great visual aid. Of course, you can also do this with a compass or just by thinking. For instance, now if I go 135 degrees from the wind, which comes from over there, and I jibe, so I'm going the other way, that means 2 times 135, which is 270 degrees. And as there are 360 degrees in a circle, that means I am left with 90 degrees. So if I jibe, now I will go 90 degrees from the current direction of sail, which makes it very easy to appreciate visually when to jibe. So I just look at 90 degrees, I see the island, I know I can't jibe. So this is very, very easy. And that's why 135 degrees is one of my favorite angles of sailing downwind, because the boat goes well. The Genoa is not under the main shadow, so it has plenty of power. You usually get a good angle towards the waves too, provided the waves are in the same direction as the wind, of course. And so it's a really nice way of sailing. And I know at any time, if I jibe, I will go 90 degrees to the current direction of sail. But of course, the ley lines on the map are very easy, because you don't have to think of all that and calculate the angles and so on. So they are a good aid. But they should call them not ley line, but lazy lines, because they certainly make you lazy. Keep going a little bit like that, and then we'll jibe. As you can see, the green line has already cleared the island mostly, so we'll wait another 5 minutes and then I can jibe. Visually, I would wait a little bit more. Isn't sailing fun?